all you can do better than that, give Jesus a hand clap. Cry, Jesus, the mist. You when we get in the storm and the battle's getting raging and it seems like there's no way that you can go, you can reach up and look up to God and call on Jesus. You say, Brother Steve, I don't know all the ways to call on God. But you can just reach down and call on Jesus and cry out to Jesus in the midst of every storm. Now, I don't care what the storm may be, you can cry Jesus. There's something about speaking the name Jesus that will move every situation. Let's just lift our hands up and say, I love you, Jesus. Oh, hallelujah. I love you, Jesus. Oh, thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Oh, hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah. I love you, Jesus. Oh, I love you, Jesus. I love you, Jesus. In the midst of the storm, cry, Jesus. In the midst of the storm, when it seems that hope is gone and you're feeling all alone, cry, Jesus, in the midst of the storm. Cry, Jesus, in the midst of the storm. Cry, Jesus, in the midst of the storm. When it seems all hope is gone and you're feeling all alone, cry, Jesus, in the midst of the storms. The disciples were sailing out on the sea, and Jesus was sleeping so peacefully. The wind begins to blow and it troubled their soul. They cried, Jesus, in the midst of the storm. Cried Jesus, in the midst of the storm. Cry, Jesus, in the midst of the storm. When it seems all hope is gone, you're feeling all alone, cry, Jesus, in the midst of the storm. All I went through a trial that was so hard to bear, and I didn't even know that anyone cared. And I thought I was sinking, then I began thinking, cry, Jesus, in the midst of the storm. Oh, let's just lift our hands up. Cry, Jesus, in the midst of the storm. That's all you have to do. Cry, Jesus, in the midst of the storm. When it seems that hope is gone and you're feeling all alone, cry, Jesus, in the midst of the storm. Oh, hallelujah. Just say it from your heart. Cry, Jesus. Whisper the name Jesus in the midst of the storm. When it seems like all your hope is gone. Oh, when you begin to speak the name Jesus, somebody comes to help you. Seems that hope is gone and you're feeling all alone, cry, Jesus, in the midst of the storms. The disciples were sailing out on the sea, and Jesus was sleeping so peacefully. The wind began to blow, and it troubled their soul. But right in the midst of the storm, they cried, Jesus, in the midst of the storm. Oh, hallelujah. Reach your hands up once again. Cry, Jesus, in the midst of the storm. Cry, Jesus, in the midst of the storm. Oh, hallelujah, hallelujah. When it seems that hope is gone and you're feeling all alone, cry, Jesus, in the midst of the storm. Just lift your hands up and tell Jesus you love him. Jesus, we thank and we praise you. That Jesus, in the midst of the storm that you promised us in your word, that you would never leave us and that you would never forsake us. But even if time gets hard, Lord, that you would stand beside of us. Lord, in this service, meet every need. In Jesus' name we pray. I love you, Jesus. Lift your hands up and say, I love you, Jesus. Oh, lift your hands up and say, I love you, Jesus. Oh, hallelujah. I love you, Jesus. I love you, Jesus. I love you, Jesus. Oh, I love you, Jesus. I love you, Jesus. I love you, Jesus. In the midst of the storm, some of you are in the storm this morning. Some of you have been out on the sea and you've been tossed here and about. It seemed like that you can't turn to the right and you can't turn to the left. You turned to your family and your family couldn't. You turned to the doctors and the doctors couldn't. Well, this morning we can reach out and we got a name that we can call on. The name that is above every name. We can cry Jesus. We can cry Jesus. We can speak Jesus. Oh, how are we going to sing it one more time? Cry Jesus in the midst of the storm. Cry Jesus. Lift up your hands. When it seems that hope is gone and you're feeling all alone, that's the time that Jesus can help you. When you know that you have no one else to call on, you can call on him. We're going to sing it one more time. Cry Jesus in the midst of the storm. Oh, this song is for somebody this morning. You're in the storm. You've done everything you know what to do. Oh, that's the time you can turn to God. And when it seems like there's nothing else to do, all you have to do is stand still and cry, Jesus, in the midst of the storm. Oh, we're going to sing it one more time. Cry, Jesus, in the midst of. Oh, hallelujah, hallelujah. Cry, Jesus, in the midst of the storm. When it seems that hope is gone and you're feeling all alone, cry, Jesus, in the midst of the storm. Jesus is the one name that you can call, that you can depend on. There's some people you can't depend on. There's some friends you can't depend on. But you can call Jesus this morning. You can cry out to Jesus. Oh, you say, Brother Steve, I don't know the way. Well, Jesus made it clear. I am the way. I am the truth and the life. And I'm so glad this morning we have somebody that we can call on. Somebody in the day of trouble that will come and help us. Somebody that loves us. Somebody that cares for us. And he said, I care for you. So you come and lay your burdens at my feet, and I'll pick up your burdens and your cares, and I'll carry them for you. Somebody just lift your hands up and say, I love you, Jesus. You may be seated this morning. Oh, hallelujah. I cried Jesus in the midst of the storm. I cried Jesus when everything goes wrong. There's something about crying out to Jesus that can help you. Hallelujah. I'm so glad that when you cry out to Jesus, that his ear, the Bible said, his ear is not deaf. His arm is not shortened, that he cannot hear and answer. And this morning we have a God that we can call on. I'm so glad that he's there. I've been on the plane that's been on fire. I've been in the automobile that was crashing. I've been on the doctors, and the doctors did not give me any hope. But I had my hope not planted in what man said. My hope was not in the situation, but my hope was in God. And if my hope is in God, I don't care what it seems like. The Bible said it's only temporarily. That I feel, hell is only temporarily. That I feel in my body, it's only temporarily. Because I'm convinced 100%, as Isaiah said, we're passing through. When you pass through the fire, when you pass through the water, when you pass through the flood, we're passing through this problem. We're not in this problem to stay. Why? Because we can cry Jesus in the midst of the storm. Give Jesus a hand clap. Paul, he learned how to cry on God. He learned how to cry on Jesus. The Bible said that Peter called on him when he began to sink. You know, when we begin to sink in the life, oh, Brother Steve, I don't know which way to turn. Well, that's the time this morning for you to turn to God. When you turn to God, God's going to help you. We're seeing a day and hour that around the world is changing. We're seeing changes in the churches. We're seeing changes in the political field. We're seeing changes where people are doing things. But the Bible said that God never changes. He's always been the same. And the Bible said, for this purpose was the Son of God manifested, that he might destroy the works of the devil. Some of you think that the devil's got to keep you down, and that you got to stay under his feet, and that you got to stay down. But I'm persuaded that Jesus Christ come that we might be healed. Jesus Christ come that we might have eternal life. Jesus Christ come that we might have victory through Jesus Christ. The Bible says in the midst of the storm, the disciples were upset. The disciples done all that they knew what to do, but Jesus was sleeping so peacefully down in the bottom of the ship. And they went down and said, Jesus, don't you care that we perish? You know Jesus cares that you perish. If Jesus did not care for me and you, do you think that he would have went through what he went through for me and you? Stop and think about who we are in Christ Jesus. We're living in a day and hour that people forgets who Jesus is. But I know who he is. He's my healer. He's my doctor. He's my friend. He's my all and my all. Oh, Brother Steve, which it don't seem like it's going to work. Well, you can come to Jesus. It's going to work. And God's going to turn it around. And God's going to turn it for your good. And that the devil set for your trap, it's going to be for your benefit. And it's going to be for your victory. Because it's going to be victory out of the problems. When you get to the place that you realize, I don't care how long the road is. And this past week I drove from Oklahoma Friday to get back here, and some of those roads are long, but every one of them, you look down those roads, you'll see a hill. Behind that hill there's going to be a valley, but on the other side of that valley there's going to be another mountaintop. Every one of us are going to go through the valleys. David said, I went through the valley. Not only a valley, but David said, I went through a big valley. David said, the valley that I remember the most is the valley of the shadow of death. I remember that I went through the big one. David said, I didn't only just go through the little valleys, but I remember the big valley, the valley of the shadow of death. Over there was the giant, And over there I was walking in my enemy's shadow, and it looked like there was no way for me going to make it. But you know what David said? But I fear no evil. Why? Because his rod and his staff, they comfort me. I don't care how big the shadow is. And some of you this morning, there's some things hanging over your spirit. There's some things that the devil's talking to you. The devil's is lying to some of you. The devil's saying you're going to die with this and you're going to die with that. And this is going to happen in your home, and that's going to happen in a home. And that's your valley of the shadow of death. You feel like you want to give up, but there ain't no time to give up. It's time to hold on to God's unchanging hand, for God's going to turn it around. You say, Brother Steve, the valley I'm going through, I want to give up and die. The prophet of old, he was sitting down and he said, I'm not as good as my fathers. I wish that I could just die. Here he was, he just had a victory. He just had one of the greatest victories the world had ever knew. But because somebody over here said you wasn't going to make it, because somebody, Jezebel, said you can't do it, Jezebel said you ain't going to make it through, some news report is going to tell you you can't, some doctor's going to tell you can't, somebody down the street's going to tell you, I know somebody that didn't. But we ain't looking to them that didn't, but we're looking to them that did. We're going to look to God's word, and in God's word, from Genesis to Revelation, I can show you where they went through, and they come out on the other side. Give Jesus a hand clap. In the midst of the storm, the disciples were on the ship, but Jesus promised them, once you get on the ship, I'm going to meet you on the other side. Disciples got on the ship, and all of a sudden, out in the midst of the sea, the storm begins to rise. You say, Brother Steve, what are you saying? Some of you know that you're in the perfect will of God. You know that God's put you in this place. You know that you're living a holy life. You know that you're living a clean life. You know you're paying your tithes. You know that you're doing everything that God told you to do. Sometimes the devil will tell you, and the people in the world said, when you will tell you the reason why things aren't going good for you, it's because you got sin in your life, because you're doing something wrong. But I want to tell you about the hand-picked ones of Jesus Christ. I want to tell you about the ones that Jesus said, pick up your cross and follow me. I want to tell you about the ones that he reached out and picked. They were in his perfect will. And they said, Jesus said, you go over to the other side. So they were doing what he told them to do. But in the midst of the will of God, and in the midst of what God told them to do, there come a storm. Just because you're in the will of God don't mean you're not going to have a storm. But be a good cheer. When you get in the storm, you're not going to be there by yourself. You're going to have somebody to help you out through the other side. Give Jesus a hand clap. The disciples looked out and the storm was raising. The Sea of Galilee is not a big sea, but it's hard to get to the shore when the wind's blowing. And it seemed like their boat was going to take on water. But as a song that I sung, Jesus was sleeping so peacefully. All of a sudden, out in the midst of the storm, Peter began to look for something. Some of you this morning, you're looking for a way out. The world's looking for a way out. But there ain't but one person we can look for. And that's what we got to look to Jesus. All of a sudden, somebody's seen something out there. This is where faith begins. Faith don't begin with a clear vision, but faith begins with a little glimpse of a vision. And all of a sudden, Peter said, I think I see something out there. They said, Peter, watch out. You're looking and you're dwelling in the spiritual things too much, you're going to get in trouble. But Peter said, I see something out there. I got a glimpse of something out there. Well, what is faith? Faith is a substance of things hoped for and evidence of things not seen. I don't see it clearly out there, but I know it's out there. You may be in the midst of your storm, but you look out there. There's an answer in the storm. And Jesus is the answer in the midst of the trials. Jesus is your answer to every problem that you might have. The Bible said that Peter said, I see something. Somebody said, Peter, watch out, you're going to get in trouble. But Peter said, Lord, I really can't see you face to face, but I can feel something out there. Lord, if that be you out there, you bid me to come. What was he saying? Jesus, I want to stay in your perfect will. Lord, I want to know if this is out there and you want me to get out of the boat that I'm riding in. I'm willing to get out even though the carnal tells me not, even though my mind tells me not, even though my friends tell me not. Lord, if that's you, I won't listen to what they say, but I'll listen to what you say. I'll get out of this boat. It's against the natural, but what is faith? Faith in the carnal, they war against one another. Faith will tell you if you can't feel it, you ain't got it. Faith will tell you, the carnal will say, if you can't feel it, you ain't got it. But faith says, you don't go by feeling, you go by faith in your God. Faith will say it's there, but carnal say it's not. Carnal will say, if you can't smell it, it's not a cooking. But faith says it's there. The Bible tells us faith is a substance of things hoped for. Some of you are in the storm this morning, and you don't know the way out, but you hold on. You hold on. God's going to turn it around. Some of you have been praying for your children. And I don't mean only started this year or last year. Some of you have been praying a long time for your children. Mama, hold on to those children. Hold on. God's going to turn it around. Give Jesus a hand clap. But Peter said, Lord, I can't see it yet. But I'm not going to go by sight. I'm going to go by your word. This morning, this is where we got to go by. We can't see it this morning, but he said it in his word. Hallelujah. I can't see it this morning, but I can speak it from his word. I can't see it this morning, but he said it was going to happen. I can't see it this morning, but if I could see it, it would not take faith. If I could feel it, it would not take faith. If I could hear it, it would not take faith. If you got $100 in your pocket, then you'll go up and you can buy $100 worth of groceries. But if you ain't got no money in your pocket and you have to trust God for it, then you'll know what faith is. Church, it's time for us. Don't look for it first, but let's stand on his word and expect it to happen. If God has ever healed you once, he'll do it again. Some of you this morning, you've been healed, and the devil seems like wants to put back on something God's done took away. Well, you stay under the blood. You stay under the stripes. You claim your healing through Jesus Christ. The Bible said when we claim our healing, something's going to take place. Around the world, the world is being shaken. You heard Pastor Dobbs and you heard myself say, keep your eyes on Israel. Then it's all going to take place around Israel. You don't know what's going to happen from one week to the next week in Israel. Things are happening so fast. Hallelujah. I believe Jesus is coming and we need to be ready. Sometimes you say, Brother Steve, I've heard it all my life. But Jesus is coming and you got to be ready. I'm convinced today more than I've ever been convinced before that Jesus is coming. There's so many people that are trying to get a form of godliness, but denying the power there within. And the Bible said, from such turn away. How many churches around the world today has got a form of godliness? How do you go into the church and you ask the pastor, you ask the people in the church, when's the last time you've seen somebody weak through to salvation in your church? Oh, they don't do that in our church anymore. You know why? Because they don't have the Spirit drawn on. It's an organization and not the Spirit. It's time that we get back to the old landmark. This may be old-fashioned, but I believe that you can cry Jesus in the midst of your storm. And I believe that when those tears begin to roll down your face, that Jesus will see the intent of your heart, and he'll see the hungry of your victory, and he'll see what you need, and he'll come to your rescue. You know, whenever you cry Jesus, something's going to take place. There comes a time in your life that you want something. I know my children will still come walking around. One of the older girls may be going to leave and one of the younger ones wants something. They'll come to the door and say, you go in and ask him. You go in there and ask him. Oh, you got children. You know what I'm talking about. You go in and ask him. But when those older children get in that automobile and start to lead, that younger one won't ask nobody else to come and ask me. She'll come for herself and ask me. Why? She knows that the car that she wants to ride in is going to leave, and that she wants to be in the car, and she ain't got time to get an answer through somebody else. It's time for us to get desperate. It's time for us to get down to business. It's time. Let's don't wait on somebody else to get the answer for us. Let's don't wait on somebody else to turn it around for us. Let's turn it around for ourselves. The Bible said that we have the authority and we have the right to go into the holies of holies and to attain mercy and to help us in the time of need. Don't let the devil cheat you out of the blessings of God. Don't let the devil cheat you out of what God has promised you. Don't live under your privilege. We are children of God, and that makes us somebody. Give Jesus a hand clap. In the midst of the storm, you look at Daniel. What did Daniel do? He didn't throw his hands up and quit, but yet he was in the perfect will of God. He was praying morning, noon, and night. He was in a perfect will of God, but yet he went through the trial. How did the three Hebrew boys, where were they? They were in the perfect will of God, but where did they go? They went into the fiery furnace, but you know what? They did not go in by themselves. Some of you this morning, you know that you're living the way that you're supposed to be living, and the devil's trying to throw a curve to you. Do you know why? He knows he can't come against the word that you believe in. He knows that he cannot come against the God that you serve. He knows he cannot stand against Jesus or the authority that he has given us, so he's trying to get us to wave the white flag and throw it in and say, I quit. The only way that he'll win is for me and you to quit. Church, this morning, I want to encourage you. Cry Jesus in the midst of the storm. Don't quit. Hold on. Don't turn loose of that you've asked God for, but hold on. God can turn it around, and he can turn it for your good. The Bible tells us when you cry, Abba, Abba, when you cry, Father, Father, something is going to take place. Peter said, Jesus, if that's really you, I don't see you in the physical, but I'll take you at your word. He said, if it's really you, tell me to come. All Peter told Jesus to do is say, come, and I'll come. And the Bible said that he spoke, come, and Peter took him at his word, started walking on the water. You know why? Because Jesus spoke it. All we need is one verse in the Word of God. All we need is one little word in the Word of God. All we need is just something to stand on that come from the Word of God, and we can stand on it. I don't care what the problem looks. And around the world, I wish that people would turn the TV off. I wish that people would turn off the radio. I wish they would throw the newspaper away. Why? Because we want to believe the report of the world and not the report of the Word of God. It's time for us to be like Isaiah. Isaiah said, who shall believe our report? We have a report that we want to preach. We got a report that we got to testify. There's a report that we got to proclaim. And the report that I'm going to bring to you this morning, that God is our way out in the midst of every storm that we got. The report that I'm going to bring to you this morning, you'll never put more on him than he can bear. You lay it all down at his feet, and you pick up your cross and follow after Jesus Christ. Some of you this morning, you think that you can get it through education. You think you can get it through your own learning. You think, man, my boss man and my company's got a plan, and it's a great retirement plan. And which is good that companies have retirement plans, but you better not put your trust in that company. You better not put your trust in that retirement plan. You better not put your trust in your money that you got in your bank. You better not put your trust in your ability. There's going to come a time that you're going to need God. There's going to come a time that you're going to have to cry, Jesus. Hallelujah. And if you've been looking everywhere else for your blessings, do you think God's going to bless you? The Bible said they come. Hallelujah. The king of Israel got together with the king of Samaria and said, the king of Edom has come down towards us and warred against me. The king of Samaria said, I got all my men numbered. The king of Israel said, my men are your men. We go out to battle together. I don't care what everybody wants to do together. I don't care if they're Democrats and the Republicans pull together, it's not going to pull this world out of the shape that it's in. It's going to take more than Democratic. It's going to take more than being a Republican. It's going to take being a child of the King to turn something around in your heart and turn something around in your life. I tell you what we're going to be living in, and I'm preaching and I'm prophesying it in the days to come, that you're going to see your next door neighbor doing without, and you're going to be given to your next door neighbor. You're going to be seeing your next door neighbor not have, but you're going to be loaning and you're going to be lending unto the others. You know why? Because God is going to show the world that he's going to stand for his people. God's going to show the world that he's going to take care of his people. Oh, Brother Steve, I don't believe it. Well, you'll be one of them that's going to be borrowing, and you'll be borrowing from the rest of us, because we're going to lend and not borrow. Give Jesus a hand clap. Oh, the King said, man, we've been out here 7 days and our cattle and our men ain't had no water. Says, hey, us three men together, all of our abilities together, we can't figure out where there's a water hole at. Are there not a water hole around? Jehoshaphat said, hey, I wish there was a prophet in the land. I wish there was a man of God in the land. The man of God can turn the situation around for us. Said, all of a sudden somebody heard, yeah, there is a man of God in the land. Well, who is he? He's Elisha. Who's Elisha? He's the water boy for one of the greatest prophets has ever been. He was the water boy for Elijah, and he knows all about water. Don't you remember how that was dry and he spoke and water come out? He knows all about water. God sent him down to the brook and he had water to drink every morning when there was drought. He knows all about the water. Where is he at? He's over here in the tent. Well, let's go in and get him. Let's go in and get him. The Bible said they went over to where Elisha was at. And Elisha looked up and he seen the kings. And he looked at him, he said, boys, why don't you go back to the God of your fathers? Why don't you go back to them and ask them to give you water? You know, there's so many people, they've got their gods sitting on not only the shelf, but their gods are sitting in the driveways. Their gods are their jobs. Their gods are their abilities. Their gods is, you know, with your education are their gods. Their money has become their gods. You know what's going to happen? You're going to separate yourself from God because you have other gods. You say, Brother Steve, what is a god? A god is anything that gets between you and your God. Either it's houses, it's land, either it's your family, anything that you put before God, it becomes your God. Why? Because that's the thing that you worshiping before you worshiping God. Oh, Brother Steve, it's straight preaching this morning. Well, church, I can hear the sound of the trumpet. The Jesus that we serve, he's coming back, and it ain't gonna be long. And we gotta get our eyes off of the earthly things, and let's get our eyes on the heavenly things. Jesus is coming, and we gotta be ready. The Bible tells us that he said, hey, why don't you go back and talk to your gods of your fathers? Well, they're a long ways away from here. He said, he looked up and he seen Jehoshaphat. He said, you know, if it wasn't for this young man here, I wouldn't even talk to you. This is what I know, that we can bring a blessing into our own house whenever there's people in our house that's not saved. That God will bless our house because we serve God. And because we inquire of God. And I know some of you this morning, some of you got husbands that's ungodly. Some of you got husbands that runs the roads. Some of you got husbands that'll do anything, any time of the day. It don't make no difference if it's wrong, they'll do it. But there's a blessing on your house. You know why? Not because of your husband, but because you inquire of the Lord. Because you look unto God. Because you depend on God. It brings a blessing into the house. Elisha said, if it wasn't for this man of God, I wouldn't even talk to you. He said, what do you want me to do? He said, you know the rules. You know you got to get in the spirit before you get anything from God. You know you got to get the carnal off of your mind. You know you got to get the thirst of the earthly things off. Well, what do you want me to do? I want you to go get me a band. I want you to get me an organ. I want you to get me some choir singers. I want you to have church. It's time for us to have church. Oh, but we're here in the tent. It don't make no difference where you are. If you want something from God, you got to get to His presence. And the number one way you get to His presence, by lifting up His name and by glorifying the name of the Lord. He said, start singing. Man, they sung in God in the spirit, and the man of God began to prophesy. He said, tomorrow morning, he said, I want you to dig some ditches this afternoon. Oh, you say, Brother Steve, I thought you was going to preach it, that I was going to get it without doing anything. You don't get nothing without doing nothing. You do nothing, you get nothing. Don't dig no ditches, you don't get no wells. And the Bible said, the man of God said, you dig some ditches. Dig the valley full of ditches. Hallelujah, but you don't expect to get it the way that you think that you're going to get it. You think they're going to come a big old rain tomorrow morning, thundering and lightning, the water's going to run out of these hills and going to fill up the valley. He said, that ain't the way it's going to be, because that's the way you expected it to happen. You know what happens to a lot of us? Sometimes we expected God to do it one way, and we're looking on this person to give it to me. If I'm going to get a raise, it's got to come through my boss man. If I'm going to get a promotion, it's got to come through him. It's got to come this way. It's got to come that way. You're looking at the wrong source. It's time for us to keep our eyes on God if we want God to turn it around for us. And he told him, said, dig some ditches. Some of us has got to dig some ditches this morning. Some of us got to get into the Word of God and start digging the little ditch. How do you dig a ditch? Do you know what you do? By faith, I dig a ditch. I don't know, but He said for me to dig a ditch. The man of God spoke it, and I believe the man of God, and I'm going to dig a ditch. What did Peter do? I don't see you, Jesus, but at your word, I'm going to do what you tell me to do. 2 Chronicles 20:20 said, to believe in the Lord thou God, and so shall you establish, and to believe His prophet, and so shall you prosper. It's time for us to get the Holy Ghost shovel out. It's time for us to take the word of God and start digging the ditches. If you want something for God, how do you dig it? You dig it with the word of God. By whom stripes I am healed. I'm digging the ditch. I'm walking by faith that He not put more on me than I could bear. I'm digging the ditch. You dig the ditch by quoting the word of God, and the devil has to get out of there. And the Bible said, the man of God said, tomorrow morning when you get up, you're not going to see any rain, thunder, but the ditch is going to be full. He said, my, but you're going to do a great work. Man of God said, this is only a light thing. This is an easy thing. Well, you know the enemies, the Edomites that's coming after you? Tomorrow morning, you're not going to see them anymore. Well, how are you going to do that? Don't worry about it. You dig the ditch. And this is what happens when faith is activated. You dig a ditch, and you see God fill it. You lift your hands and you praise Him for filling it. It increases your faith, and then you see your enemy, and then you don't see your enemy anymore. Why? The God that we serve is able to increase our faith. And this morning, I haven't even touched the sermon I had going to preach. I had not even read the text, but I felt this morning that somebody was crying out to Jesus, and that somebody was in the midst of the storm, and that somebody felt like giving up. Somebody said, God, I was in your will. I'm doing what you tell me to do, and I'm still fighting this battle. Hold on. God's going to turn it around, and He's going to turn it for your good. While Brother Ralph comes to the organ this morning, give Jesus a hand clap. When you ask God, God's going to turn it around. Some of you this morning, you don't know how God's going to do it, but God's going to do it. I don't understand everything there is about God, but I've learned to trust Him. I've learned to depend on Him. Some of you remember a few years ago, we give the testimony. I was coming in on Interstate 10. It's back when my grandpa was living. He was out in, he lived out the backside of Becker County. We were bringing some cattle into the market for him and pulling a horse trader filled up with horses, with cattle and the horse trader. And I got to I-10 and Baldwin exit. And I was in my right lane doing what I was supposed to be doing and keeping between the lines, and a big truck come over. And I swerved to miss him, but I did not know there was a big concrete embankment in front of me. I knew there was no way for me to stop. It was either hit the truck or hit the concrete embankment. But me and my wife together was riding along. And I slammed on brakes. You know, there comes a time that you slam on brakes in life and nothing happens. Comes a time that you do something that you know that should stop your problem, but it don't stop your problem. It makes it get worse. I slammed on brakes and the trailer began to jackknife around. But something that just come out of my heart and come out of my spirit, Me and Sister Willeen at the same time, I shut my eyes, got ready for the impact, and I spoke one word. I cried Jesus. When I said Jesus, I shut my eyes, and in the physical, I was waiting for the impact, but the impact didn't take place. I opened my eyes up a few seconds later, and I looked behind me. The smoke that was from the big truck's tires was not there. How I got over on the other side, and I'm talking about, you know, across the railroad tracks, and there's probably 10 or 12 tracks under. How I got over on the other side with my eyes shut, I never know. The only thing that I know, that I was in trouble. And there was no need in calling on my friend. There was no need in calling on my prayer partner. There was no need saying, I got a good boss man. There was no need saying, I got a PhD and I got a lot of education. The only thing that I concerned, and out of my spirit, I cried Jesus, and something took place. I tell you what I believe. I believe that God picked me and the cows and the horse trailer and the van up and set me on the other side. You say, Brother Steve, how do you believe that? The next day I went back to see what happened, and I seen my black marks, and the black marks went right up within about 2 feet of hitting the concrete, and I should have hit it. It was headed for it, but the black marks stopped, and I was on the other side. I don't know how I got over there, but the only thing that I know, that I called Jesus, and Jesus was at my rescue. Don't tell me that you can't cry Jesus, and Jesus turned it around. I want everybody to stand up. I want everybody to stand up and lift up your hands. Oh, hallelujah, hallelujah. And you're feeling all alone. Some of you that way this morning. Cry Jesus. Oh, hallelujah. Cry Jesus in the midst of the storm. Oh, lift your hands up. Cry Jesus in the midst of the storm. That all hope, when it seemed like the doctors give up on you, it seemed like there's no way for your family. Cry Jesus in the midst of the storm. We're going to sing it one more time, and just lift your hands up. Tell Jesus your problem. Tell Jesus your problems. Oh, hallelujah. Cry Jesus in the midst of the storm. Seems that hope is gone, and when you're feeling all alone, oh, remember this one thing. Cry Jesus in the midst of the storm. Oh, hallelujah. We're going to sing it one more time. Cry Jesus in the midst of the storm. Somebody this morning, you need Jesus. You've undergirded your ship. You've done everything. You know what to do. Just because you're in the storm don't mean you're out of the will of God. You hold on to the promise. Feeling all alone. Jesus. Oh, let's slip our hands up and sing it one more time. In the midst. Oh, while they're singing that, I want you, if you say, Brother Steve, I've been in the midst of the storm. You say, Brother Steve, I need the church to pray with me this morning. Which I'm going through a trial, I'm going through a problem. I got a problem in my home, a problem on my job, a problem in my finances. In my spirit, I've been troubled. I need God to help me this morning. And you need God to help you this morning. And you know that God can help you this morning. I want you to come down. I want to pray for every one of you this morning that you have a need in your life. And you're in the midst of the storm. It don't mean that you're out of the will of God for you to be in a storm. Oh, that's the one that the devil wants. That's the one the devil wants this morning. Oh, hallelujah. Are you in a battle? Do you need God to help you? Oh, hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Oh, yes, Jesus. I begin thinking, if I could just cry Jesus, if I could just speak Jesus, something will take place. Oh, they're going to sing it again. Cry Jesus in the midst of the storm. Oh, hallelujah. Yes, Lord. Yes, Jesus. In the midst of the storm. Oh, hallelujah, hallelujah. Lord, we thank you this morning. Thank you, Jesus. Lord, we thank you. Lord, we thank you for complete healing in Jesus' name. Oh, crying Jesus. Crying Jesus. Yes, Lord, you said that you would make a way for us where there seemed to be no way. Lord, we can stand on your word. Cry Jesus. Lord, keep this young man saved. The storm. Oh, hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Just lift your hands up. Speak the name Jesus. Midst of. Yes, Lord. Oh, thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. When it seems like all hope is gone, when there's nowhere else to turn to, God, we turn to you. Lord, we speak it. Lord, the nights of praying, the nights of tears, turn it around. In the midst of the storm, turn it around. In Jesus' name, yes, Lord. Yes, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. A trial. Lord, bring her out of it, Jesus. Bring her out of it, Jesus. Yes, Lord. Yes, Jesus. Yes, Lord. Yes, Jesus. Yes, Lord. This day, Lord, we dig those ditches. Lord, fill them up with your blessings, Lord. We stand on your word. Lord, in those ditches and around those ditches, put your angels. Put your spirits. In Jesus' name, Lord, what are your children, Lord? A daughter of Abraham, Lord, cause her to be blessed. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Oh, hallelujah. Oh, this sermon was for some of y'all this morning. Hallelujah. Crying Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Yes, Lord, touch this body. Oh, yes, Lord, your children, God. This day, God. This day, God. Oh, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Yes, Lord, this day. Jesus. 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 Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Move back. Lord, we move back. Lord, we move back the strong weapons of the devil. We move back the arm of the flesh. Hallelujah. That meant to do harm. Lord, we put your angels there. In Jesus' name. Lord, touch this brother, Lord. Let it happen as a Lord, he is even asked. Yes, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Let it happen. Let it happen. Yes, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Yes, Lord. Reclaim it. Lord, reclaim it. We claim it. We claim it. We're living in your will. In Jesus' name. Oh, hallelujah. Yes, Lord. Yes, God. Lord, the prayer, let it happen. The prayer, let it happen. Yes, Jesus. This day, Lord, touch my brother. Lord, keep him, Lord. Lord, keep him blessed. In Jesus' name. Oh, hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Yes, Lord. Lord, this day. This day, God. Lord, crying Jesus in the midst of the storm. Lord, crying Jesus. Lord, we can't, but you can. Lord, we take you at your word. We stand on it. God, turn it around. Loose it, Jesus. Loose it, Jesus. Loose it, Jesus. Lord, speak to them, God, and turn it loose. Speak to them and turn it around in Jesus' name. Oh, hallelujah, hallelujah. Jesus, in the midst of the storm. Oh, yes, Jesus. It seems that all hope is gone. And you don't know what to do. We can cry Jesus. We can cry Jesus. We can cry Jesus. Turn it loose, God. Oh, hallelujah. Let it happen. Cry Jesus in the midst of the storm. Oh, hallelujah. Jesus in the midst of the storm. Oh, hallelujah. See, when it seems like all your hope is gone, there's no one else to turn.
Thanks for watching this awesome video clip. If this sermon has been a blessing to you, help us out as we put more of these videos online. It takes thousands of dollars to put these videos online. Please go to PaxsonRevivalCenter.com and donate to help us spread the gospel to everyone in the world. Go to PaxsonRevivalCenter.com and click on the donate button. God will bless you.